Good morning, students. Today I am here to explain the sixth poem of our course book, The Way Through the Woods. The present poem is written by Rudyard Kipling. It was first published in 1910. The poem describes a scene of forest. Once there was a road, there was a path through the woods, which has now become overgrown and cannot be seen easily. Once again, the present poem, The Way Through the Woods, it is written by Rudyard Kipling, which was published in 1910. The present poem describes a scene of forest. Once in the forest, there was a way, there was a road. Now it has become overgrown and cannot be seen easily. Now let's understand the poem. The first lines, they searched the road through the woods 70 years ago. Weather and rain have undone it again, and now you would never know. The first four lines of the poem. In the beginning of the poem, the poet has mentioned of a road through the woods which was closed, which was searched 70 years ago. It was searched, it was closed due to weather and rain and lack of use. The present poem, The Way Through the Woods. In the introduction, we have seen that in the forest, once there was a road, but it was closed. So the road which was there in the forest, it was shut, it was closed 70 years ago. And this was done because of weather and rain and also lack of use. Even we are observing that in monsoon season, in farms or at deserted places, various plants, grasses, they are grown. And due to that, even small narrow passages, they are not visible later on. In this poem also, in the forest, once upon a time, there was a road. But now, it was closed because of lack of use and weather and rain. Second stanza, four lines. There was once a road through the woods. Before they planted the trees, it is underneath the coppice and teak and the thin anemones. In the second stanza, in the second four lines, the poet has said that once there was a road through the woods, but now it is not found as it has been disappeared. It has been disappeared beneath the bushes and different kinds of plants. In the second four lines, the poet said that once there was a road through the woods, but it is not found now because it has been disappeared. It has been disappeared beneath, means under the bushes and different kinds of plants. Now that road is not visible to human eyes. It means the road which was there once upon a time, it is hidden from the human eyes. It means human beings, they are not able to see the road which was there through the woods once upon a time. Next four lines, only the keeper sees that where the ringed out roots and the badgers roll at ease, there was once a road through the woods. In this line, the poet said that only the keeper knows that where the road was. The keeper, it means one who looks after the forest. Only that person knows that once upon a time there was a road through the woods. Now, the road which is not seen and a part of the woods itself is full of activity and life. How the poet has said that? As it is occupied, the road, it is occupied with ring dove that broods there. Broods, it means hatch their eggs. And the badgers, that is carnivorous animals that can burrow into ground which rolls in it. The road which was there once upon a time, it is not found nowadays. But that road, it has become now full of activity and life. The poet has said that on this road, now it is under the bushes and different kinds of plants. So here the ring dove, they come to breed, to brood there, to hatch their eggs. And the badgers, they are rolling in it. So this suggests that the road which was there once upon a time, it has been disappeared and it is now full of activity and life. Ring dove as well as the badgers, they are found on this road. Actually, the road is not visible, but where the road was there, now it has been replaced, it has been hidden under the bushes and different types of plants. And on this road, there are ring doves as well as the badgers. Next, four lines. Yet, if you enter the woods of a summer evening late, when the night air cools on the toad ring pools, where the otter whistles his mate, they fear not men in the woods because they see so few. In these lines, the poet said that now, if anyone visits the woods or anyone goes into the woods in the late summer evening, he or she, that person will come to know that there is more to the road. The road is not exist. The road was there in past. But when any person visits the woods in late summer evening, that time he or she will observe that there is more to the road. Now what a person will observe into the woods, or especially the place where the road was situated. The night air pools above the pools that are full of fish, and the otter calls out to its mate. The atmosphere where the road was located is now full of activity and life. Here we have come to know that the night air, it cools above the pools that are full of fish. The otters, they would like to call their companions, to call their mates. So this suggests that the atmosphere is full of activity and life. Besides that, these creatures, they do not fear the human presence, because now the people, they dislike to visit the woods. The people hardly visit the woods. So there is less presence of humans in the woods. So these creatures, they do not fear human presence. And the last remaining lines. You will hear the beat of a horse's feet and the swish of a skirt in the dew, steadily entering through the misty solitudes, as though they perfectly knew the old lost road through the woods, but there is no road through the woods. In these lines, One could hear, the poet has said, that any person could hear the beat of a horse's feet when he is passing through the woods. And this sound of horse's feet, it seemed as a ghost of horses. Because when there was road during that time, the men, they used to ride on horseback on that road. But now the road was not exist, but there also one could hear the beat of horse feet. So this suggests that perhaps it is a ghost from the past when the road was used by men on horseback. Then one could hear the sweep of skirts moving amongst dew covered grass. Even person could hear the sweep of skirts. And finally, in the last line, what the poet has said, but there is no road through the woods. It means the poet still feels that there is surely no road through the woods. In the last line, the poet has said, but there is no road through the woods. The poet has said such thing as the road is totally invisible because now it is covered with bushes and various plants. Once upon there was a road through the woods, but now it is not exist. It is totally covered with various plants as well as bushes. So this is about the poem The Way Through the Woods. In this poem, Rudyard Kipling has mentioned a scene of forest. Once upon there was a road through the woods, but due to weather and rain and lack of use, the road is disappeared. On this road now there are different plants as well as bushes, but the activities of birds and different animals that make the atmosphere of this road live. This is about our poem The Way Through the Woods. Thank you, students.